his name, Jefferson Ramirez. Here he is. You've met him before. Jefferson, good night.
Good night, good night.
Small shoulders, but responsible shoulders. Saturday night, you had to really put the cap on things and say, okay, folks, this is where we close the lid. End of story.
Yes, it was very tough after seeing so much wonderful singers and outbursts of different talents. It was crazy.
So were you scared going on?
Not really. I wasn't, because I said to myself, I'm going to do this for God, and no nervousness, no anything wrong, because we normally do things for ourselves and not checking the real man upstairs. So I said, like, this is for God, so let me go to do my best and, you know, just finish it off with a bang.
But I know, and I think you really did. I mean, starting with just the way you presented yourself. There we have you on stage, and we'd entertain some of that performance, and we come back with Jefferson.
It's what I long for. Holiness is what I need. Holiness, holiness is what you want for me.
Jefferson, you look back on that performance. And I let you be the judge. You judge. You tell me.
I don't know what to say.
Do you lead worship in church?
Yes, I do.
So it wasn't just Jefferson going there to sing on Saturday night. You were just into your thing that you usually do.
Yes, it was totally. Because, even placing fifth in the competition, it wasn't really, I was not really happy about that fact of coming fifth, but to minister to people. And to see people lifting their hands and crying and actually saying that, when I sing, I make them want to give their life to Christ. That was the stuff that actually made me happy after experiencing the results. And coming fifth is why be disappointed when you really need to, one, minister and you actually fulfill the purpose that you went to the competition. So that was really the whole thing of
but
that.
But I think listening to people, and in the weeks that we spent on one-on-one, people would meet me in the road, and it seems as if you went into the competition as the crowd favorite. And I'm sure you've done an excellent job from the day of the audition until Saturday.
Yes. Being the crowd favorite was...
It put more pressure on you.
Yes, it did. But...
There was this gentleman, Jefferson. You set up somebody to come there with this big banner. I had to pull him back.
No, I didn't.
I'm only teasing you. I'm teasing you.
He came and he was members of Touch of Grace and M4L, one of the members couldn't make it. So she decided to make posters for me and Denison. So when I saw the posters, I was like, what going on? So I was like, because nobody else had posters. And that was the only poster I saw. And it was very big. And
the gentleman came and put up this big poster, and I had to go pull him back a little bit because he was barring the camera for a while. You think that maybe must have taken away from your performance?
No, not really.
Okay,
not
good.
Really.
All right, so where to from here?
I won't stop singing at all. Grenada, you can look out for me. Seriously, look out. I'll be performing and getting calls and stuff like that. So,
you've been getting calls as a result of participating in the Gospel Challenge?
Even before.
Okay.
Taking part in, especially the finals, I have concerts to sing in. I have women, somebody came to me and asked, let's talk business and stuff like that.
Oh, wow. Let's talk. So, can I be your agent?
But finally, I would like to thank God first. First of all, I really like to thank God because preparing for this competition was not easy. Practicing was not easy. Then trying to go and do your best. It really wasn't easy, so I really want to thank God. I want to thank my mom for, being there every time, and waiting up for me after practice and stuff like that. My aunt, Auntie Rose, Auntie Ruth, my manager. She's, my manager. It's, everything I needed, clothes, everything. It was, just want to say thanks to my church. The whole Madiga crew just came down there and supported me to the fullest. My pastor, everybody, people were telling me, don't come back up here if you ain't win that, But I went and it was good criticism so far, some bad, some good. My class, the graduating class of 09 PBC, Mr. Jeremiah, thanks for supporting the Touch of Grace, M4L, Common Cheros, Sister Noel, everybody. Just behind me, just to do this thing. And I never used to sing. So it just caught everybody by surprise and that I could sing and, I was going to say thanks.
Congratulations.
Yeah.
And I noticed that a lot of work and thought preparation went into your performance because you were singing about holiness and you ensured that you had your purity outfits, it's your white outfit to go with that song.
That was not planned, but before I had something else and then the week came, and Auntie Ruth came and she said, well...
The manager came.
Yes, and she said, well, that'd be a good idea. And we just went and just improvised from there.
Auntie Ruth, you're getting a lot of kudos here. Your nephew is very thankful to you for the role that you have played. Anyway, that's where we bring the curtains down on Jefferson Perez. Congratulations and keep on singing. Brokenness, holiness is what you call for. And he really did give his best on Saturday evening.